The most ancient cratonic nucleus of Indian continent was formed about 3600 million years ago. This nuclear growth led to the formation of what we know today as the Aurora Craton. The Aurora Craton is divided into two units, Eastern Aurora Craton and the Western Aurora Craton. Based on the age they formed, the lower unit of the Aurora Craton is called Older Sequence, that formed before 3000 million years ago, and then the Aurora Supergroup, which formed about 2800 to 2600 million years ago. At last, the younger granitoids, which formed about 2600 to 2500 million years ago, along with Charnocitization. During the initial period of crustal growth, when small magma differentiates formed, they were quite unstable. They were being repeatedly digested due to high heat flow. At the crust mantle boundary, partial melting caused magma generation, and eventually they cooled to form granitoid rocks of Gorur group. This happened about 3600 million years ago, but most of the rocks date back to 3300 to 3400 million years. Soon after this, ultramafic mafic lava erupted and deposited as greenstone belt. As this greenstone belt deposited, crustal loading over Gorur gneiss caused sac duction and temperature and pressure to be increased, which caused partial melting and produced TTGs in Gorur group of rocks, which were migmatized and now called Gorur gneiss. They formed basement to Sargur group. About the same time Sargur group formed, Warangal group deposited in similar fashion, but what formed the basement to these is quite not clear. With the deposition of Sargur group in Western Dharwar Craton and Warangal group in Eastern Dharwar Craton, one cycle of crust formation was over. Granitoids which belong to Peninsular gneiss intruded at 3000 million years ago into the Western Dharwar Craton. Peninsular gneiss formed basement to Dharwar supergroup. Some TTG plutons also intruded in Eastern Dharwar Craton to form Archean Dharwar batholith. About 2800 million years back, Baba Budan group, which is another greenstone belt, deposited and caused partial melting of older crust to form TTGs, and these are another component of Peninsular gneiss. This was followed by the deposition of Chitradurga group. At the same time, Dharwar supergroup of Eastern Dharwar Craton deposited. As Dharwar batholith started to subduct under Western Dharwar Craton, first Yasantnagar formation as a linear greenstone belt and followed by Kolar group. With this, Dharwar supergroup was finally deposited, and the final deposition is dated back to 2600 million years back. Now, as subduction continued, Eastern Dharwar Craton was sutured with Western Dharwar Craton along close plate granite. Now, about this time, that is 2600 million years back, as Archean period was about to be over, the crust was stable enough that it was not to be intruded with another ultramafic mafic magma episode. As a result, they accumulated below the crust and caused metasomatism, that caused transformation of amphibolite rocks of Craton into granulite rocks. This extent of metasomatism is marked by Fermor's line and is also called transition zone. Metamorphism was also caused by younger granite placement due to widespread cratonization about the end of Archean. But the granulite belt has an east-west trend on plan view today, so this does not sound right. This in fact can be explained by block rotation. The entire Dharwar Craton was uplifted and tilted by an angle of about 5 degrees that exposed about 25 km in south and 10 km in north, and erosion exposed the granulites from deeper level. In Eastern Dharwar Craton, the extent of metasomatism was more than Western Dharwar Craton. This is marked by the presence of Karimnagar granulite belt in north of Eastern Dharwar Craton. This is how Dharwar Craton formed, which was first of Deccan Protocontinent. Thank you for watching and subscribe to InfiTele for more videos and updates.